in my case, music is, well, everything, and everything else is superfluous. That's probably a terrible state to be in, but I just live and breathe music. Whether it's playing guitar or playing the piano or listening to records or collecting records or watching music videos or all sorts of stuff like that. My whole life revolves around my ears. Even if I were to lose my hands or something, wouldn't be able to play, I think the worst thing for me would be to go deaf. I mean, that would be the end of my life, and that's all I do. I just live music. I'd love to be able to have a house full of vintage guitars, but there are so many people collecting guitars that most of the nice ones have already been collected, and they're sort of sitting around in ex-Jimi Hendrix roadies' lofts, sort of collecting money. This is a Schecter. Now, this is a sort of nuclear-powered Fender Telecaster design, but it's made out of really beautiful materials. The woods are wonderful, and it's got this beautiful natural sustain. I don't know exactly what the wood is. I think it's ash. And the neck is maple. And these pickups are beautiful, and it's a very expensive guitar, but a beautifully made and wonderful sounding guitar. And I love it. And I love this too. This is really a jazz guitar, so I've got absolutely no business owning it. But this thing is about 22 years old, I think. 1959 this was made. One of the first Gibson Stereo ES-355s to come off the production line. It's got this beautifully tacky tortoiseshell scratch plate and a little selector switch here that's got these wonderful archaic presets. Talk about primitive onboard EQ. It's really, really, you can get sort of real Chet Atkins sort of sounds out of it. But it's once again, it's a beautiful instrument, and you want to see the case it came in. It's wonderful. The pink lining goes with the cherry finish beautifully. And this thing, this is the world famous Rickenbacker 12 string. World famous because it was, famous for producing noises like things like and of course, who could forget?
Coming from inside your
Managers are in it for money, and that's the difference between managers and groups. Groups are in it for their art, for sake of a better word, and managers are in it to make money. That's why they're there. And never the twain shall meet, and that's why groups and managers are always falling out. And record companies, once again, are the same
as
managers.
That's my theory, Chris, and I'm sticking to it.
Well, why have managers in the first place?
Why have them? Because when you start off, it's absolutely taken as written that you're going to be green and inexperienced, and when you're green and inexperienced and all you're doing is champing at the bit to get out and make records, somebody comes up in your lowest hour, your lowest kind of spiritual strength, you know, I must make records, let me at those records, you know, and they say, well, there, I'll let you at these records, just sign here. And of course, you know, you're not even looking, you just want to make records, you know? and that happens to most people. And of course, when you started making records, you think, well, that was great, I've made a record. No, did I sign something? And then you start looking around and you see that you are firmly concreted up to here in contracts, and you're held, you know.
Also, people tell you that you need a manager as well. You know, it's like a guitar. You're gonna need a manager, you know.
How to be in a group.
Oh, yeah,
let's see.
You're probably right.
We got the list. Guitar, suit. Wig, suit, manager, kinky boots. Yeah, oh, what's missing? Manager.
Part of the ammunition, you know.
So for anyone who's going to watch this programme and who's thinking of starting into a career in music, or maybe they're already with a band or they've just got a dream, is there any bits of advice, instantaneous?
Yeah, I mean, you've got to do it. If you want to do it, the only thing's to do it. If you want to climb a mountain, it's no good saying, well, I'll build a little one in my living room and run up and down it and that'll give me the sensation. No, you've got to do it. You've got to go and do it.
I think my advice would be don't sign anything.
Yeah, don't
even a lolly wrapper.
That's the best advice. If you can do it without signing, if there's any way that you can be kind of sharp enough, just hold back the enthusiasm a little and be sharp enough not to actually sign anything, because bands have done it on not signing anything, then do it, because if you are signed, it can so easily be turned against you very shortly, and you can be picked up by the ankles and shaken of all your cash.
If they want that badly what you've got to offer, then you won't need the paper at all.
Yeah.
You can pay them, you know, you'll come to an agreement with them what you're going to pay them without signing anything. You know, you can do that.
Yeah, there's been a lot of talk about money. Do you think there's any way in which the music industry should be changed?
Should
help
changed.
The situation? How would you like to see it, Ron?
There's no way back for the music industry now. It'll just disappear up its own little hole in the middle of the black plastic. It's got so geared to consumerism and commercialism, it's got so finely honed that they now make the music to fit the requirement rather than trying to sell the music. Do you see what I'm saying? They don't say, okay, well, they've made some music, let's go and sell this. Nowadays, it's, could you make it more, yeah, that's right, okay, now we know where to place that. You know, it's like brick making. Yeah. If you make a brick that's slightly triangular, that's not any good. They can't flog that because they can't fit it in. They can't fit it in the wall. You know, they can't get it in there. But they know that people are going to want these little square bricks. So you know, you make a square one. Oh yeah, we can sell that.
And that is why we're so out on a limb, because you know we're not doing that. We're making the music that we want to make, and we're saying to the record company, okay, there it is, go and flog it.
Yeah, which is what everybody should be.
Like a palm from the speakers and wheel. I'll be radio. so cold. Between the lines so cold. Between the lines so cold. Between the lines so cold. Push, push, tactics are driving me loco.
Well, apart from XTC's advice on how to keep your head above water in the music world,